Anand Estevez.
Yeah.
Bombay-based Goan, son of the famous Sarto Estevez. Tell us about your late dad. I remember him as the author of this well-known book, Politics and Political Leadership of Goa.
That was one of the books in between.
But in the 1980s, that was a book which was...
It started, I think, in the 70s. The first book was Goa and Its Future.
Goa and Its Future. Which year? I've seen references to that, but I've not seen the book. Who published it?
Out of the market.
Out of the market.
I don't know who's the publisher.
E-book Korun Sod Mare. E-book Korun Sod Mare.
E-book?
Yeah.
Okay.
Either OCR or even just PDF, you know, because these things need to be read.
I got one or two copies with me.
Goa and Its Future is 1960s or 1970s?
I think it is 70s. 60s.
Maybe just after liberation.
Yes, after.
This liberation thing is that.
Must be late 60s.
Or maybe even mid 60s.
Possibly.
But why I remember was, why I remembered
because
politics
that was the first book in Goa.
And political leadership. Uh-huh. Was because it was extremely popular. I still remember the cover. It's in my collection, of course. Blue and yellow stripes.
Yes.
With a big bold heading. Mm-hmm. And Sarto Estevez, the name which we cannot forget. And those days, there used to be very few books on Goa. Maybe 8 or 10 available in the market. Mm-hmm. And this was one of those. So, you remember your dad as what? What age? First memories of him. Which part of Bombay?
We were always living in Chembur. Until this day. I was born and brought up in Chembur. And even today I am staying in Chembur.
Chembur was a very quiet place at one stage when you were young?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Like a village?
No. Much before I was born.
Okay. Okay. Your 60s. 63?
65.
Yeah. What are your first memories of your dad? Always writing?
Always. Yeah. Either books or articles, letters to the editor.
Behind his typewriter?
No, he never typed.
Handwritten.
He should be always writing it and giving it to someone or the other to type.
How many books he wrote?
Around 8 to 10 books at least.
Which are the others?
I can't tell you offhand. The last book was Freedom to Build and Not Destroy. That was brought out after
the attacks,
the riots and
Graham Stein's attacks on Catholics and Christians.
That period, when the attacks took place.
Yeah, 90s, mid to late 90s.
Beginning of the 90s. When the attacks took place, then the right until the Gujarat riots.
Okay.
2001.
So he was writing till which year?
That was the last book.
The second last book. Okay.
Then another book on all this collection of articles on Christmas.
Yeah.
Which was brought out much later.
Yeah.
2006, I think.
Yeah. So Anand, he had a very strong Christian identity also.
Yes, yes.
He was a lay Christian leader. He was a lay Christian leader.
Yes, yes. He used to help out a lot with the priests and bishops. And
but very much of an Indian nationalist also, no?
Yes.
As obvious from your names, Anand. The reason for your name being?
He just wanted an Indian name.
Indian name, Joy. How many kids? Siblings?
I got a sister.
Name?
Rashmi.
Rashmi. Rashmi means? We'll have to check out. But Anand obviously means Joy. So your dad used to write a lot. He was a prolific writer. And in between he ran his business of advertising, related to advertising.
Yes.
Which is called?
Aminar Advertising.
Aminar. Named after?
No, just a coined word.
Okay.
Coined a name.
Not after initials of some people.
Yeah, all are initials.
I see. Aminar.
Yeah.
Very interesting. Anand and Rashmi at the end.
Yeah.
I see. And would you say that in those days, Goan Christians were dominant in the advertising, publicity, printing sector in Bombay?
Not printing exactly. Advertising. Definitely advertising.
Your dad was one of them.
Hmm.
Where did he study and when did the family migrate to Bombay?
He came alone to Bombay.
He came alone?
Yeah.
In the 30s, 40s? He was not yet married.
No, no. Must have come in 30s.
From which village? From. Which village?
Not 30s, must be 40s.
40s.
Raya.
Raya. So he is born in the 20s or 30s? 30s.
1990.
Sorry?
Early 20s. 1919.
He is born in 19. From Raya he moves to Bombay. Any other memory, something he told you about him or early life or challenges or the arts, foods, culture? Because Bombay was a huge place for Goan culture.
Yes, no? But mostly he was into this
writing
and involved with church matters.
Writing in English?
Yeah. He would write only in English.
How did he want to be
not
remembered?
Just books only, even articles.
Yeah. Examiner?
He was very famous for writing in the Examiner.
Where else?
Examiner. Then after he started writing for Indian Currents, he used to write for the newspapers, Goan newspapers.
Yeah.
Herald and Navan Times.
I see. Oh, Herald, the English edition of Herald. I think I encountered his work there also.
Yes.
So you had these Goans scattered across the globe who, however far they were, never gave up on their Goanity thing, no? Quite a few of them, no? Serious,
yeah,
because
yeah.
They kept writing and they kept being involved with Goan life and, you know, hats off to them.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on him as a person, as a writer?
Well, yeah, his writings were read by a lot of people.
Yeah.
And even the bigger books used to sell. Of course, books, there were not too many books. And it was all topical books, you know, so...
But they did get noticed. They did get noticed.
Yeah, definitely.
He passed away in his 80s or...
90s.
90s.
Yeah.
Long life, yeah? Long life. All the best. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.